We're back and you're watching live at 9. Beverly Robertson officially takes over as the Memphis Chamber's interim president and CEO in January.
She replaces the late Phil Trenary, who of course was shot and killed during an attempted armed robbery last month. It is a difficult transition, no doubt. And as a woman, as an African-American woman, you're making history doing it. Of course, you're used to making history.
Yes, you are, Beverly.
Look, I was really privileged and honored to be offered the opportunity to really step in and stand on the shoulders of Phil Trenary and Clifford Stockton, who worked with the chamber for many years. And as I talked to the staff the other day, I reminded them that I can never replace Phil Trenary, but what I can is make him proud, have him walking around heaven up there clapping for the good things that we plan to do to extend his legacy.
What are some of those things, Beverly? I know the community would like to know, what do you plan to do and hope to do to, again, as you said, extend that, because there's still so much work to be done here.
There is a great deal of work to be done, and you know the chamber has three or four major objectives. They have to attract new business.
Right.
They need to retain existing businesses, because sometimes I think we focus on the new to the exclusion of the retention piece. And then they need to focus on the public policies that make it difficult for us to do business. So I think those are the things that I would say will anchor the work. But I also think that when you look at minority business development, that is such a critical piece of this whole objective with the chamber.
I was just going to ask that, because you are also a business owner. You and your husband own your own company. You, of course, led the National Civil Rights Museum for decades. You have an interest and a passion for social justice and equality in our community. And how much more does the business community need to do? The chamber was working toward that.
Yes.
But there needs to be more.
Absolutely. When you think that 64% of the population at one time got less than 1% of the contracting opportunities.
Right.
When you look at the fact that there are 40,000 small and minority businesses in Memphis, and about 2% of them have two employees or more.
Right.
That to me says that we've got a lot of work to do to be able to address that void. That's not, that's a crevice and a void that exists in the market.
And Beverly, when we talk about the issue of diversity though as well, especially to groom our next leaders here in the city. We all know that a lot of people say that has not been fully embraced and addressed here.
Right.
What are we doing there to make some of those black CEOs or business leaders, female CEOs, part of this discussion as well?
Well, one of the things that I believe is, I believe the first thing requires awareness. Sometimes I think people don't do because they think they know.
Yeah.
But they don't really know until they look at the data and someone communicates it in a way that makes it viscerally connect with them.
Right.
That's the first step, awareness. The second thing they got to do is they need to understand that in order for us to attract businesses, we've got to change the operating environment, which means we got to address poverty.
Mm-hmm.
We've got to address minority business development.
Mm-hmm.
We've got to really understand what it is going to take. It's going to take an investment of time. You know, in Memphis, we used to have vocational education.
Mm-hmm.
We don't. We need to realize that everyone's not going to college and not going to be college bound.
Everybody can't be in marketing or IT or...
Everybody cannot.
Right.
But what we need to do is think about a continuum of training and education for those people who dropped out of school, for those people who are out in the market, displaced, marginalized, and disenfranchised, and for those individuals who are ex-offenders. We've got a whole pool of people out here that need to be trained to do a specific job and need to be paid. And there are some creative ways I'm thinking about doing that.
So we can say that the chamber perhaps we'll have less of an image as old, white, and male.
I think you can't debate that with me.
With you at the helm, you're right about that.
I think it speaks to a new focus and perhaps a new direction to address opportunity for all. And that is really what is on their website.
Mm.
So we're going to see if we can't allow and make sure that they live up to the words opportunity.
Because they want to.
So hopefully we'll open some other minds as well, so they'll see the bigger picture.
Absolutely. One of the things I want to do is I really want to spend some time getting to know those business leaders that I don't know.
Yeah.
And working with the chamber on lots of important issues and challenges.
All right, Beverly.
That's awesome.
Look forward to having you back on Live and Out many times.
Oh, that wasn't enough time.
We'll have you back. You know we will. We want you back. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Glad to have you at the helm.
Appreciate your continued service to the community.